Well, here's the matchup we've seen throughout this series. The top line against top lines. Marc Schessault has been excellent. Nobody's been better at scoring goals than Mark Scheifele. William Karlsson, one of the best two-way players we've seen in the playoffs. They lean on their captain, Blake Wheeler, to do a lot of the heavy lifting for the Jets.
The team that has scored first has won all four games in this series. Jets kill off the first power play attempt. Puck in behind the Winnipeg net. Quick decision there by Hellebuck. Morrissey can't get it out. Turnaround shot, score! Alex Tuck! The Golden Knights take a 1-0 lead.
Here's the play by Hellebuck. Here's the deflection right there off a skate because of the pressure. It goes off Carpenter's skate. Here it is again. Hellebuck made a good play there to clear it. And then this one. There's the bounce and the goal.
And again, the pressure of Vegas creating fits for the Jets defense.
Right, he said we just have to play our game.
Yeah, they've come out and they've certainly started that way. They've looked not nervous by any means.
In fact, they were pretty loose down by their locker room before the game when we were down there. Saved by Hellebuck on Belmar.
Scheifele plays save. The puck. Pardon me, Kenny, that's a big save. Belmar had an excellent chance.
Face off to the left of Fleury, controlled by the Jets. Buffalin with a shot. Fleury covers.
Dustin Buffalin, second on the Jets in shots on goal in the playoffs, gets this one through, and good play by Fleury as he had to look through. Look at that. All those players in front of Fleury, and he's able to step to the side and find the puck and make a save.
Well, late call. Morrow off Nosek. All the Knights did not have possession, so Buffalin moves in and a pass save by Fleury. Winnipeg for the power play. Jets applying pressure. Now Wheeler with a minute 10 to go on the penalty. Buffalin with the puck. This is Wheeler across from line A. Waits, shoots, misses the net.
And then line A over on the other side has a chance, takes his time, and that shot misses the net because Karlsson comes over and gets a piece of it with his stick. Certainly in Winnipeg, but Vegas is right into it.
Little wins the draw shot by Morrissey, score!
Morrissey, left side of your screen. He starts going into it as soon as the puck is dropped. What a shot and a perfect face-off win. Little beats Karlsson and Morrissey ties the game.
You can see Marchessault trying to get his stick on it, but you can also see that left leg come up. In this situation, you need to come up with a block for your goaltender. It didn't happen.
Carried back by Nate Schmidt for Riley Schmidt. Now Marchessault with a shot. And the save made by Hellebuck.
I'm not sure Marchessault got everything on the shot. It was a very good setup. And Marchessault with the wrist shot. And again, Hellebuck gets a piece of it but doesn't quite hold on and has to reach out. Here it is again. The pull, the shot, didn't get everything. And Hellebuck is able to control it and hold on.
Good stuff by the Vegas defenseman.
Wheeler, Scheifele, Connor on the ice for Winnipeg. Shot by Scheifele, knocked down by Fleury. Wheeler with the puck, another save by Fleury. He leads the league with 14 postseason goals.
Yeah, well, this is, he's got an unbelievable wrist shot that probably doesn't get talked enough about. There it is again. And that's a good reaction save by Fleury. His ability to get the shot through with something on it, one of the best in the game.
But it certainly seemed to wake up this crowd as Fleury typically would grab that with ease.
Eric Haula with the puck for Vegas, turns and shoots, loose in front. It was near the goal line but did not cross.
Yeah, I think it was right on the goal line. You know, Brian talked about it earlier in the game. He's had some difficulties handling the puck. This is just bouncing, rolling, but he had a lot of players on top of him as well. Some bumping. This will be a better look. Wow, and then off the post. I didn't see that the first time. So when he cleared it out, he cleared it first off the post and out.
On the drop pass, it's broken up. Banged ahead for Neal by Tuck. James Neal shoots. Hellebuck can't find it. He made the save. And now he covers.
Out of the zone, and then he comes right back afterwards and takes the quick shot. Hellebuck thinks he has it. He doesn't. And eventually he's able to cover up with Tuck looking for a loose puck.
Hellebuck, a Vezina Trophy finalist. Spezza with a shot, score! 2-1 Vegas!
Fourth line again, Ryan Reeves got a stick on this one.
Great job by Spezza too to find a lane. He dragged it to the middle and then got back to the outside, and you see Ryan Reeves from that angle was able to get a stick on it, making it awfully difficult for Connor Hellebuck to react. And it goes right off the crossbar and in. No chance for the Winnipeg Jet netminder, but a good job by Spezza to find a lane and get that puck to the net.
Into the Winnipeg zone, drops it off for Schmidt. Schmidt shoots. Net has come off behind Hellebuck. Finally a whistle.
Good strong play by Schmidt. He takes the drop pass from Belmar, and that puck nearly went in the far side, and then you can see the collision with the net by Bufflin.
Armia, shoved by Theodore, shot off the skate of Theodore. Armia with it again, sends one across now. Bufflin fires, and Fleury moving from right to left, makes the stop.
You had a good view of that, Brian, didn't you?
Yeah, I mean, watch this little stutter step. Fleury knows he's in trouble, and then he's got to get across real quick, and Bufflin doesn't fan on this one. He got all of it, and Fleury showing his athleticism and his quickness to get across. Watch him right here. A little shimmy step there to get across, and Bufflin frustrated once again by the goaltending of Marc-Andre Fleury.
Now Smith looking for it. Carlson and Trouba. Smith comes over towards the net. Marchessault out in front. Carlson stopped. Big save by Hellebuck.
Just when you think you've got it, you don't. And there's the beautiful pass, and what a save that was by Hellebuck to keep his team in it.
Oh, an awfully difficult save. When that play originates from behind the goal line and Hellebuck is able to get across on his knees and get that right shoulder on, or left shoulder on it.
Neal beat Morrissey to it, and it's skated out by Tuck. Tuck tied up by Wheeler. Puck comes in front, and a big stop again by Hellebuck, this time on Ericola.
What a pass! And that's another big save by Hellebuck.
I've really liked Alex Tuck's game here today. He scored the goal early on a turnover, and then that play right there, Joe, you're right. I mean, it's about 1 inch. I mean, you just got to get your stick out there and make a play. Tuck was able to do that, and another huge save by Hellebuck.
Down to 10. Here's Stastny, hit by Marchessault. Scheifele to the puck. Time winding down. 27 days after their first regular season game in franchise history, the Vegas Golden Knights are headed to the Stanley Cup Final.
It's been a fairy tale, started that way, and it's just continued to grow from the early tragedy in October, and how this team and these individuals and that organization tried to help a city heal from that. And they just continued to grow. That man on the left there, the head coach, is going to be coach of the year, and it's not even close. And that goalie there is the MVP in the playoffs thus far, and I don't think that is all that close.
And yes, he did touch the Clarence S. Campbell Bowl.